Hi, I'm Scott. Let's explain everything whiteboard. It went through a big update in the February of 2018, and I decided that I would just walk through the entire app so you can see what it can do and some of the features that you might not know about. So that means this video is going to be pretty long, so just use the description part and you can find links to different parts of the video so you don't have to watch the whole thing, or you can watch the whole thing if that is how you would like to walk through the entire app. So just use pause, you know, back up. If you need to hear things again, go ahead and do that. Otherwise, let's get started. So when you open up Explain Everything, what you first see is a new home screen. And with that, you'll see kind of the top where you can start a new project with the plus sign. Join, that would be if you are joining a collaborative account that's different than the Explain Everything whiteboard, which used to be Explain Everything classic features. Those are different, as well as where you could share stuff. Then you can see kind of where recent projects are. With the recent projects, right, they just kind of all line up. As you can see, some of them I was just kind of practicing and trying some things, and they're entitled, and I can title them later, and that's okay. I will do that. Next is Learn. As you can see, there's this new Learn feature where if you click on them, they kind of have some really nice-looking kind of graphics to show you and just little pinches of information. Really the opposite of this video, what you can do. And so do explore those. You could go through. So that's the new home screen. Next, if you go to the library, this is kind of what you used to just see. And it has all of your videos as well as the recovered ones right there. You could go ahead and access those there. Learn is kind of has those quick tips that like we just saw, right? But also, what it has is posts from their blog, and so there's kind of a lot of real cool features there, a lot of places to learn. You can, a lot of good stuff there, as well as their help section. Like you can see, pulls up this document, which has really helped me make this video. And it's a really helpful document that explains exactly what things do, as well as the Explain Everything Academy, which is kind of a MOOC that you could go through. Let me take that off reading mode. There we go. You can sign up for, it's free, and you can go through and kind of learn everything that way as well. All right, and then there's other links, website, and that sort of thing. And then search is what you would think. Search, it would search your text. It does not search your handwriting. So that is the home screen. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm going to get started by hitting the plus sign, right? The purple plus sign. All right. Now, there's a kind of a difference here. One, now that we're getting started, we could import from import resources or projects that are already out there, right? So, for example, I could say import from cloud, and I already have a project, say, in Box. And I'm going to click here, and I already have an Explain Everything project, so I could open that up. But as you can see here, I also can open up PDFs and bring them straight in and just start with them there. I could bring in PowerPoint or Keynote slideshows. I can bring all those in when I'm starting, but I'm not going to do that right now. So I just hit cancel. I'll go back. So I'm going to hit the plus sign again. I could choose portrait or landscape mode, right? Landscape mode is kind of how our eyes are oriented and how computers are oriented. So I usually try to stick with that unless you have a very specific purpose to do that. Then what I really like here is now you have the ability to choose other, see there's dots, kind of a chalkboard feel, off-white, as well as custom templates you can create. As well as just choose random colors. So it doesn't have to be one of these eight that are here. As well as graph paper, right? So those are all kind of important changes that you can make. So, but right now we're going to start just with blank. So I'm going to hit the plus sign there. All right, cool. Now this is our screen. And so I'm going to just start with walking us through this entire thing. So, in generalities, and then as we go, I'll every single icon and button I will break down and show you what it can do, and maybe even give some possibilities on how it could be used. So first, I'm going to start, as you can see, kind of over here. And now I had it on pen mode, though. I'm going to go back there. I'm going to go to the hand tool first, and then this will help me kind of show you. So here, right, this is the toolbar. This is a great where you're going to access all of your tools and user interface that way. Next is zoom, so you could kind of zoom your screen. It's an infinite canvas, so you can kind of go in and out with your hand. So that can be handy. Here's where you would record, and then a mic button. This will get bigger once you do record. It gives you more options. It limits the options that are there when it hasn't been recorded yet. So here's the slide sorter, and to create more slides, that's down here. Up at the top would be where you would change the project name, as well as to kind of quick save it. And then over here is where you would share, hence where it says share, as well as the ellipses, right, the three dots kind of will take you into settings. You can minimize everything. And then over here, right, where our it says projects, that just takes you back to the home screen. Or if you want to start a new project, you would want to start there. All right, cool. All right, let me get rid of that. Perfect. All right. Moving on. We're going to start with the most basic aspect, which is the pen tool. I don't know if that's actually the most basic, but that's where we're going to start. So I have my pencil here. I'm using this on an iPad Pro, and so I am using the Apple Pencil. I feel like it works really well that way, but you could also just use your finger on another iPad, an iPad Air or so.